Hello class A. So let's continue our physics class. We were doing chapter number 3, force and pressure, in which I told you about thrust and pressure and the factors affecting pressure. Now today we do what you mean by liquid pressure. Children, you know that every solid exerts a pressure on the surface on which it is kept. In the same way, liquids also exert pressure on the container in which they are kept. But the difference is that when a solid is kept on the surface, it exerts pressure only in the downward direction on the surface on which it is kept. Suppose this is a solid, it is kept on a tabletop. So it will exert the pressure. That will depend on the weight of the solid, and the pressure will always be exerted in the downward direction. But in case of liquids, liquids also have weight, but they will exert pressure sideways also on the container in which they are kept. Suppose this is a container in which a liquid is filled up to this level. So this liquid will exert pressure equal to the weight of the liquid in the downward direction. Plus, pressure is exerted sideways also. Liquid will exert pressure on the walls of the container also. So this is the difference between pressure exerted by the solid and pressure exerted by a liquid. Now these activities will prove that liquid exerts pressure at the bottom, sideways. In fact, liquid exerts pressure in all the directions. So for this you have to take a glass tube. Now you tie a balloon at the bottom of the tube. Now here the tube is empty and we have tied a deflated balloon at the bottom. Now if we will pour water in the tube, we will observe that the balloon will bulge out. So why does the balloon bulges out? This is due to the pressure of the water, which is acting in the downward direction. So this proves that water is exerting pressure downwards, and this pressure is equal to the thrust upon area. Thrust is a force exerted by the water, perpendicular force exerted by the water, which is equal to the weight of water and upon area of this water volume. Now this activity will prove that the liquid also exerts pressure sideways. Now we have taken a glass tube with a side opening and we have tied a deflated balloon at this opening. Here the tube is empty. Now if we pour water in the tube, we will observe that the balloon bulges out. So what is causing the balloon to bulging out? The pressure of water. Here we have filled water. So that means the water is exerting pressure and the balloon bulges out. The water gets filled in this balloon. So this also proves that the liquid is exerting pressure sideways. The liquid exerts pressure in the downward direction. The liquid also exerts pressure sideways. Now you take a balloon and fill water in it, and you make holes at the sides by using a pin. By inserting pin, you make holes. Now you will observe that water will start coming out through each hole. So this shows that water is exerting pressure in all the directions. That is why it is coming out through all the holes. So this shows that a liquid exerts pressure in all the. Now next is the factors affecting liquid pressure. The pressure at a point and in a liquid depends on two factors. First factor is the height of the liquid column, and the second factor is the density of the liquid. Children, the length of this liquid filled in any container is called the liquid column. The area occupied is called the liquid column. So the first factor is height of the liquid column. More the height of the liquid column, more will be the pressure exerted by the liquid. See, we have taken two glass tubes in which we have filled water up to two different levels. And here we have tied balloons at the lower ends of the glass tubes. So here the level of water is less. So the balloon is less bulged out. Here the level of the water is more. So the balloon is more bulged out. So here the height of the liquid column is less than the height of the liquid column filled in this glass test tube. This shows that more the height of the liquid column, more is the pressure exerted by the liquid. The next factor is the second factor is the density of the liquid. More the density of the liquid, more is the pressure exerted by the liquid. This activity proves this. Here we have taken two identical glass tubes and we have filled water in one tube and mustard oil in the other glass tube. The level of the column, here the water column level and the mustard column level is same. Height of the column is same. And same type of balloon we have tied at the lower end of the glass tube. But we see that the balloon tied at the lower end of the test tube filled with water is less bulged out as compared to the balloon tied at the lower end of the tube filled with mustard oil. This is showing that the mustard oil is exerting more pressure on the balloon. This means that more density, more pressure, because mustard oil has more density than water. So less density of the liquid, less pressure will be exerted. More density of the liquid, more pressure will be exerted. Now, consequences of liquid pressure. The thickness of walls of a dam is increased towards the bottom. Children, you must have seen a dam. So you can see that as the height of the liquid column is increasing downwards, as we are coming downwards, the walls are becoming thicker. So why does they have such a structure? This is because of the increasing pressure towards downwards. As we are moving, this is the water collected in a dam. These are the walls of the dam. So here the height of the column is less, so pressure exerted is less. As the height is increasing downwards and downwards, as it is coming, the height of the liquid column is increasing. We are observing from above. So from above the height is increasing in the downward direction. So the pressure is also increasing. Here the pressure is less, here more, 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 and here the pressure exerted is the most. So the walls are made thicker at the bottom to withstand such a high pressure. Otherwise the water pressure will break down the walls. So this you have to keep in mind. As we are coming downwards, the height of the liquid column is increasing, so pressure is also increasing. So the walls of the dam are made thicker at the bottom. Now next is atmospheric pressure. Like liquids, gases also exert pressure. Now you know our earth is surrounded by air. Earth is surrounded by an envelope of air to a height of 200 kilometers. This envelope of air around the earth is called the atmosphere. Now you know air has weight because air is also matter. The weight of air exerts thrust on the earth. The thrust on unit area of the earth's surface due to the column of air is known as atmospheric pressure. Children, you must have heard about atmospheric pressure. And the value of atmospheric pressure is about 10 to the power 5 Newton per square meter. That means 10 to the power 5 Newton or 100,000 Newton pressure is acting on every 1 square meter of the surface of an object. Now at sea level on the earth's surface, the atmospheric pressure is taken as 76 centimeter or 760 millimeter of mercury column. This is the standard value of atmospheric pressure, which is also equal to 180 m. Atm is the unit of atmospheric pressure, or 1.013 into 10 to the power 5 pascal. Now children, one more thing that the crushing can experiment given in your book. You can read it, the activity 10 given on page number 50. This proves the occurrence of atmospheric pressure. Here a thin walled tin can is taken, which is provided with an airtight stopper. First you remove the stopper and fill the can completely with water. Now you heat the can over the flame of a burner till water begins to boil. Now the air pressure inside and outside the can is the same. When the steam starts coming out of the opening, put the stopper and remove the can from the burner. Then place the can in a tub and pour cold water on the can. You will notice that the can will collapse. So why does the can collapses? The reason is that the steam has driven out with most of the air from the can. The air takes the steam along with it. When cold water is poured, the steam condenses into water and water occupies less volume than the steam. So there occurs a partial vacuum in the can. There is empty space in the can above the water. So the air pressure from the outside now becomes more than the pressure inside. So more pressure from the outside causes the can to crush. So this experiment shows you the occurrence of atmospheric pressure. Now some examples in daily life to show the existence of atmospheric pressure. When you suck a drink from a straw, what happens? How it is possible to suck a drink? When you suck from the straw, so the air goes into your lungs. So the air pressure inside the straw decreases because empty space is created. So the atmospheric pressure acting on this liquid from outside pushes this liquid inside the straw and it goes into your mouth. Similarly, when we blow air in the balloon, it bulges out because of the pressure of the air exerted which is filled in it. And also the same way the ink gets filled into the fountain pen. When you take a fountain pen, you press the rubber. So when you press the rubber ball at the head of it, then air pressure inside that tube decreases. So the ink gets filled into the tube due to the atmospheric pressure acting from outside. The water is drawn up from a well by water pump because of atmospheric pressure acting on the water in the well. The syringe gets filled with the liquid when its plunger is pulled up due to the atmospheric pressure acting on the liquid. You use rubber suckers as hooks in kitchen and bathroom. So how do they remain pressed against the wall? It is due to the atmospheric pressure. When you press the rubber sucker, vacuum is created between them and the wall. So the atmospheric pressure from the outside causes them to stick into the wall. It is difficult to take oil from a sealed tin if only one hole is made on it. But if you make one more hole, so what happens? The atmospheric pressure acts on the oil due to the air entering in the tin through the other hole. And the oil then comes out of the tin through the other hole easily. How lizards are able to move on the wall and stay wherever they desire? This is because their feet behave like suction pads. So they remain pressed against the wall due to the atmospheric pressure. Similarly, the astronauts and mountaineers have to wear a special type of suits to protect themselves from the adverse effects of low pressure prevailing at great heights. Children, one more important thing, as the height increases, the atmospheric pressure decreases. So for this reason, when you go to high altitudes, your nose starts bleeding. Because at high altitudes, at high height, like at mountains, the atmospheric pressure is very low. But the pressure inside the human body does not change. The human body contains blood, which also exerts pressure. So here the outside pressure is less and inside pressure is more. So the pressure exerted inside the body, which is more as compared to the atmospheric pressure, causes the nose to bleed. So these examples show the existence of atmospheric pressure.